So yesterday on this channel, we talked about the brand new evidence in the Tara Reade Joe Biden story, where according to Ryan Grimm of The Intercept, there was a 1993 Larry King live show on CNN where Tara Reade's mother called in to talk about her daughter's story and Joe Biden. And at the time, we didn't have the audiovisual clip, but now we do. And I'm going to play it for you in just a second. But my broad view is, as it has been for weeks, that because of this story, there's only one reasonable option forward. Joe Biden must drop out.
We're back. A couple more phone calls on this very important topic. Our guests are former United States Senator Howard Baker, Richard Allen, former National Security Advisor, and Lois Romano of The Washington Post. San Luis Obispo, California. Hello.
Yes, hello. I'm wondering what a staffer would do besides go to the press in Washington. My daughter has just left there after working for a prominent senator and could not get through with her problems at all. And the only thing she could have done was go to the press, and she chose not to do it out of respect for him.
Or she had a story to tell, but out of respect for the person she worked for, she didn't tell it.
That's true.
Now, but these are the people who do come to the Lois Romanos, right? The staff worker who says, I want to let you know about what's going
this
on, either
going
with my boss or the guy down the hall.
Mm-hmm. And a lot of these people have a sense of obligation. They feel that this public official should be accountable if it's something wrong.
They're whistleblowers to the press.
So you can see that that's the clear audio-visual clip. It matches the transcript that Ryan Grimm reported on yesterday in The Intercept and that we covered in my previous video. It's black and white. That is Tara Reade's mother. No names are mentioned, the specifics aren't necessarily hammered out, but in the broad context of when this was told, when Tara Reade's story was happening, where the call is coming from, what Tara Reade has said regarding this call, it is her mother. I fundamentally believe that, and I think most reasonable people will believe that as well. And this is a powerful piece of evidence, because it's one thing to have a transcript, but it's another to have an audio-visual clip that people can hear, that people can feel in a more direct and visceral manner, just reading a plain piece of paper. And I think that's really going to have an effect on some folks. And on its own, this piece of evidence isn't necessarily groundbreaking. If the whole story was just based on this, it wouldn't be enough. And in a court of law, this might not be enough either. But as part of the broad context of Tara Reade's story, this is an important contribution because I think it puts to question one of the fundamental lies from the Biden camp, which is that this story is 100% a complete fabrication. That this story is less than nothing. There wasn't even the whiff of controversy from Tara Reade and Joe Biden back in 1993. But when you combine it with the fact that some people have said that Tara Reade was basically demoted after bringing this story up in 1993, and when you combine that with the fact that Tara Reade said that she only told a few people, her mother being one of them, and then her mother relayed the story in an anonymous manner to Larry King Live on CNN, it makes you think that Tara Reade is telling the truth, that this story is at the very least credible. I feel this is an important contribution. And as I said weeks ago, when this story first broke, the only reasonable path forward for the Democratic Party and for Joe Biden is to have Biden drop out, and if he doesn't drop out, to force him out. I understand the will of the voters. I understand that the voters picked Joe Biden. I think they were wrong to do so. I think they made a mistake, not only on the matter of Tara Reade, but on the broad ideological questions and on the questions of his mental fitness regarding his cognitive decline and dementia. But they made that choice. Nonetheless, the Democratic Party also has to recognize that the man they're putting up for their presidential ticket has done some awful things to multiple people, not just Tara Reade, but many others. And at some point, the organization has to balance that with the reality of the people's vote. This is about who is going to represent your organization on the presidential ticket. And most of those votes were cast before this story broke. Now, it's possible that people would have heard the story and they wouldn't have changed their approach even a little bit. But many people might have. If this story would have broke in the same way it broke in January versus, April, then we might have had a different outcome. And people can't retract their votes. So from my perspective, the only reasonable path forward is for Biden to vacate the nomination of the Democratic Party. And again, if he doesn't, he must be forced out. Now, you might say, Christo, you're just doing this because you want Bernie to be the nominee. And I do want Bernie to be the nominee. I think he could still become the nominee. And I think that Bernie Sanders would be an infinitely better nominee than Joe Biden. I'm not denying any of that. But what I'm saying is that even if it's not ultimately Bernie that replaces Joe Biden, someone has to replace Joe Biden. Someone without the personal and political scandals of Joe Biden must be the nominee. I understand that he's polling in a position right now to win, although I don't necessarily believe those polls will hold, given all the stories we're hearing about Joe Biden. But I also know that there are many Democrats that could be put up and defeat Donald Trump. And that while Joe Biden is the presumptive nominee in that he's the only one currently running, you know, Bernie Sanders suspended his campaign, it doesn't necessarily mean that if it goes to convention and he can't win an outright majority on the first ballot, that somebody else could be chosen that appeals to the party and doesn't have the personal and political scandals that Joe Biden has. This is a moment for the Democratic Party, and indeed Joe Biden and those close to him, to show some leadership, to reckon with the fact that there are consequences to actions, even 30 years ago, that when men in positions of power do what they did, even when they're in your own party, it doesn't just have to be Brett Kavanaugh or Donald Trump, that those men are held accountable to what they did. And I think that putting Joe Biden out of the nomination or Joe Biden stepping aside from the nomination, doing the right thing, is what we need to see right now. I don't necessarily think that's going to happen. Maybe that's wishful thinking, but I fundamentally believe that if they keep marching forward with the man that did this to Tara Reade, if they keep marching forward with the man that has these personal scandals regarding dementia and cognitive decline, if they keep marching forward with the man that stubbornly rejects Medicare for all, even though it's supported by massive amounts of Democrats and even a majority of independents, they're walking into an election where they will lose. Biden is not somebody that deserves all of this benefit of the doubt. We know who Joe Biden is, and Tara Reade's story is a far more believable portrayal of who Joe Biden is than what Joe Biden presents himself as in 2020. And that's my fundamental belief. Do the right thing, Democrats. Joe Biden is the presumptive nominee, but he's not locked in yet. Turf him, pick someone better, defeat Donald Trump, and show women across America and the world that you actually walk the walk when it comes to believing them.